In this lesson, you're going to learn about AWS App Runner, and we're going to go straight into a hands-on lesson as well. So what is App Runner? Well, it's a fully managed service for deploying containerized web apps and APIs. So with a very simple CLI command, for example, or of course we could use the console or API, we can create a service using App Runner. Now note that we've got some configuration. We would need a config document, and also we need to specify the image repository. And this is using the Elastic Container Registry. So ECR is where we can store the images for our containerized applications. So with running a command like this, App Runner is then going to create a service. Now, when it does that, firstly, it needs a source. So the source, as I mentioned, can be the Elastic Container Registry where we have our container images. It can also be a GitHub repository. So that could be where we're getting our code or images as well. Now, next, we can define as part of the service auto-scaling if we want to be able to auto-scale our application. And we can attach a load balancer as well. Also, we have health checks to make sure our applications are running well and various networking settings, such as adding to a VPC. Lastly, there's also the ability to add observability using the tracing service AWS X-Ray. So after that, essentially what happens is everything is built on the back end for us. We don't have much visibility into it. What we get in eventually is a URL like this where we can visit our application. So it's essentially a platform as a service or PaaS solution with all the components managed. You simply bring your code and container image. So it's a bit like Elastic Beanstalk, though it's more focused on web apps and APIs, and it has some capabilities built into it for integration with GitHub, ECR, and for automated deployment life cycles as well when you update your images. So that's essentially what App Runner is. Let's go to the console and build a solution on App Runner. I'm logged into my account, and firstly, I'm going to go to EC2. And what I'm going to do on EC2 is launch an instance and use that instance to push an image for a container up to the Elastic Container Registry. So ECR is going to hold that image, and that image is going to be used by App Runner. So firstly, I'm simply going to launch an instance, and I don't need to change much. I'm just going to use the Linux 2 AMI, T2 Micro. I don't need a key pair. I can leave the default VPC. I don't really need to change anything at this point. Let's just launch this instance. And as soon as it's ready, I'm going to connect using Instance Connect. So it looks like my instance is ready to connect to. I'm going to click on Connect and connect again. And this will put me on the command line. Now in the course download, you'll find the AWS App Runner directory, and there's a couple of files. The first one is this push image to ECR. And we've got a few commands to run. So we're just going to run these one by one. So firstly, I'm just going to switch user to root. Then we'll just go ahead and run yum update. And there's nothing to update. Then I'm going to run yum install docker. That's going to install docker. And I just type yes or y and hit enter. So we'll have docker installed, and then we're going to be able to pull down an image and then create a repository and push the image to the repository. That's effectively what we're doing. So the next thing to do once we've installed Docker is we're going to enable and then start the service. So firstly, we'll run this command, enable Docker. Next, we'll run the next one to start the service, and that's done. Now I'm going to clear my screen, just bring it down to the middle so you can see a bit more easily. Next, we're going to run docker pull nginx, and that will pull the nginx web server image from the Docker repository. And that's done. So now if I run Docker images, we can see that we have this nginx image. And that's now stored on our EC2 instance. What we want to do is upload this to the ECR repository that we're about to create. All right, so what's next? We need to open this document, and we're going to use the policy and attach it to a role which we're going to use for the permissions we need to create the repository. So simply open that file. You can copy all of this code to your clipboard, and let's go to IAM. So I'm going to open the IAM service, and all we're going to do is create a policy first with that particular code, and then we're going to create a role which we can attach to EC2. So you've done this before, you know how to do it. Let's create this policy, and I will call it ECR policy. Let's go next, review, give it a name, and then create the policy. And then let's go to roles. We're going to create a role, and the AWS service will be EC2. Click on next. We're going to search for our policy. Here it is. Click on next again, and then let's call it ECR role and simply create that role. So we should be able to attach this to EC2 now. So what I'll do is go back to EC2 and let's select our instance, go to actions, security, modify IAM role, and then of course select ECR role and update. So now our instance should have permissions. So let's go back and see what we need to do. Back on the push image to ECR document, you can see the commands we need to run now. So we're going to create a repository. It's going to be called Nginx in this region. So all I need to do is simply copy this command. Back on my command line, I'm going to run the command. And there we go. That's worked successfully. For the next command, we need our account number. So I'm going to go copy my account ID from here, come back, and simply replace this account number here. And we can see it's in three locations in this document. So I'll go ahead and replace all three right now. There we go. And let's run this second command. So this is going to tag our image before we actually upload it. So again, I'll clear the screen just to bring it down to show you what's going on. Let's tag our image. That's done. Then we're going to run this command, which uses the ECR get login password and the region specified, then it pipes the login, username AWS, password, SDD in, and then we actually have the image name here. So let's paste that in, hit enter. Login has succeeded, so that's great. And then we'll come back and push our image up to our repository. So again, I've pasted that in, hit enter, and it's going to push the image. And that shouldn't take very long at all. So once the image has been uploaded, what we're going to do is go to ECR. There we go, it's done. Now let's go and have a look in ECR and see if it's there. So I'll open the Elastic Container Registry. And here we can see our repository name, Nginx, and here we've got an image with a tag latest. So that's ready. Now we can go to App Runner. I'm going to open the AWS App Runner service in another console. In App Runner, I'm going to create an App Runner service. So now we get to choose either a container registry or a source code repository. If you choose source code, then you need to connect to Git. We're going to use a container registry. It's going to be ECR, and we need our container image URI. Now, the easiest way to do this is click on Browse, choose your image repository, mine's Nginx, and then the image tag as latest. Click on Continue. We can then define the manual or automatic setting here. Manual means that we'll start the deployment ourselves manually, and automatic means that when you push a new version of your image with another tool, then it will pick that up and it will automatically deploy your code. So what I'm going to do is choose to create a new service role and leave this on manual. Click on next. I'm going to give it a service name. I simply called it my app service. I'm going to change the port to 80 because Nginx will listen on 80, and I'll leave the CPU and memory settings. We then have the option to choose auto scaling if we want to auto scale. I'm not going to do that. You can configure your health checks. You can configure the instance role used and the KMS key used, and you can change the public access to custom VPC if you want to. Lastly, it has observability with X-ray tracing. Now I'm going to leave that as it is. We're not going to change any of those settings for this exercise. So next I will click on next, and that's all good. I think I'm quite happy with the settings. Let's create and deploy our service. So the service is now being deployed, and you can see that we have an ARN. We can see the source repository, and here we have the URL. So once it is ready, we'll be able to use this URL to see our application. And it will take a few minutes for the deployment to take place. So the service is ready, and it took several minutes from service creation until it was set to the status running. And so now it is running and I should be able to use this link to access my service. So I'm going to copy this link and in a new window here, I'm just going to paste that in and we can see welcome to Nginx. So that's it. It's created our Nginx service on the back end. And all of that, of course, is managed for us. This is essentially a platform as a service solution, which is really good. You can see activity here. You can see some metrics about the service. If you're using tracing with X-ray, you'll see that here. And of course, you can come back and modify your configuration if you need to. You can also link custom domains. So if you want to use your own domain rather than the one that's offered by AWS, then you can come and link that here.